Hello, my dear students. Good afternoon, good morning, depending on the time that you watch this video. This is teacher Miguel, and today, my friends, today's lesson is going to be about very similar English words, okay? In this lesson, you will learn about the difference among very similar words. Let's start, okay? Everybody is welcome. Here we have the category of words that we're going to learn today. Effective versus efficient. Suitable versus appropriate. Benefit versus advantage. Distinguish versus difference. Let's see. If something is effective, it is good at achieving goals and accomplishing the desired results. If something is efficient, it works in a way that doesn't waste resources. Effective. It accomplishes goals. An effective diet helps you lose weight fast. An effective medicine cures a disease. An effective solution successfully resolves the problem. Remember, this is for effective. Efficient, no waste in process. An efficient machine functions while using a minimum amount of energy. An efficient process is one where there are no extra or unnecessary activities. Efficient, no waste in process. An efficient machine functions while using a minimum amount of energy. An efficient process is one where there are no extra or unnecessary activities. An efficient worker is someone who doesn't waste time or effort. For example, a factory produces shoes, but the machines are old and waste energy, and there are too many employees who make mistakes and waste time. Then the factory is effective. Why? Because it accomplishes its goal of producing shoes, but is not efficient. Suitable, appropriate. The word suitable describes when something is good to use for a specific purpose. The word appropriate refers more to what is expected culturally or socially. Suitable, good for a purpose. A winter coat is suitable for keeping warm. A laptop case is suitable for protecting your computer from damage. Look at the verb, my friends. It's suitable for, and the verb, and the main verb, is in the ing form. Okay? Pay attention on that. Appropriate. Socially acceptable. Nice clothes are appropriate for a job interview. It is appropriate to kiss your spouse on the mouth. Okay? Remember, appropriate for, that is for a noun. A job interview is a noun. And appropriate to is for verbs, okay? Both. Benefit and advantage. Both benefit and advantage refer to a good thing. Benefit can be both a noun, a good thing, and a verb. Get good things or be helped. Look at these verbs, okay? The only slight difference is that advantage is sometimes used in the sense of comparison, being better than something else. Let's see. Doing exercise regularly has many benefits. All the students will benefit from the new classes. Here, benefit is being used as a verb, meaning the student's experience will be better. So remember, my friends, here, benefit can also work as a verb, okay? One advantage of studying online is that you don't need to drive to school. Being tall is an advantage in basketball. Here, my friends, you are using advantage in the sense of a comparison. Here you are comparing two things or two situations, okay? Let's see. Distinguish and differentiate. Both mean to observe, understand the difference between things, so they can often be used with no difference. A more common way is to tell the difference. For example, I can distinguish differentiate, tell the difference between Australian English and New Zealand English. So here, remember, my friend, you can use any verb, distinguish, differentiate, or tell the difference, okay? Remember, it's more common to say, I can tell the difference between Australian English and New Zealand English. Listen, both of them or all of them are correct, okay? But however, in more conversational English, it's more common to say, tell the difference. The word differentiate can have the additional meaning of to make something different, to cause a difference, not just to observe it. For example, let's imagine you and your classmates are working on a school logo. Someone might say, our school logo is too similar to the other school. We need to differentiate it a lot more. Here is make it different, make it distinct, okay? And here my friend is also a verb, differentiate. Also, if a person is described as distinguished, that is an adjective, that means that the person is famous, excellent, or has a great appearance or behavior. For example, he is a distinguished person, or she is a distinguished person. Why? It means that he's famous, or he or she is good at something, okay? For example, an artist, or a scientist, a teacher, or a doctor. Very good, my friends. So thank you very much for watching this video, and I hope you enjoyed it. Remember my piece of advice every day, my friends. You must study English every day. These words, you need to write these words down on your notebook, copy my definition, and then make up your own sentence, okay, my friends? You have to use these verbs using your own examples. If you just copy my examples, that's good, okay? You're learning that way. But it's much better if you personalize those verbs into your everyday life. Very good, my friends. Thank you very much, and see you next class. Thank you.